Far side, Kate Schulte for a three. She splashes it.
Woo. Look at that.
Shot clock at seven, lining with a runner. Off the glass, the hoop of the horn.
LNKTV Sports and Nebraska Wesleyan University Sports Network presents Prairie Wolves Basketball. Today it's a conference matchup featuring the Beavers of Buena Vista University and your Nebraska Wesleyan University Prairie Wolves. This game is made possible by Lincoln Electric System. It's your electricity, own it. And Nebraska Wesleyan University. Now let's take you out to Snyder Arena with Jeff Motes and John Harris.
Hey, good evening, folks. We welcome you here to Prairie Wolves Basketball on LNK-TV and the Nebraska Wesleyan Sports Network. Once again, I'm Jeff Motes with John Harris as we get you ready for the men's matchup here tonight between Nebraska Wesleyan, number six in the D3Hoops.com top 25 rankings, against an undefeated Buena Vista ball club that's under first-year head coach, former Prairie Wolf, and former assistant Wesleyan coach Trevor Johnson. This Buena Vista team was down here last weekend for the Snyder Classic, had an impressive showing, stayed undefeated. They're back here for a second time in about a week.
Well, we hope it's an inauspicious return for Trevor as he comes back to Nebraska Wesleyan. Glad to have him back with a team that is formidable, to say the least. But Coach Wellman, the Wesleyan is coming off, you know, two 100-point games, beginning to get their stride. Nate Shimonitz is playing out of his mind. Of course, you got to have Hiller and the rest to come on board. But this is going to be a tough game here tonight.
There you see head coach Dale Wellman, 117-35 in six seasons here at Wesleyan. Two seasons ago, national champions, two-time national coach of the year, three straight conference titles. He's got the makings of another team that could make another run for a conference championship.
Well, the one thing about Coach Wellman, he doesn't recruit guys just to be practice player. Everybody on that bench knows at some point in time, you better be locked and loaded. When you get in the game, you're expected to run, you're expected to shoot, play some team defense, and contribute to this ball club.
Let's look at the head comparisons. When you look at the two top players, there you see Trevor Johnson, the former Prairie Wolf, Lincoln Pius, a 10th graduate, and first-year head coach at Buena Vista, off to an 8-0 start. He's scored over 1,000 points here at Wesleyan. But when you look at the head-to-head between these two top players that we're going to see tonight, Nate Shimonitz, again, who averages 25 points a game. He's a senior. And you look at Timothy Jeffries, the other guy for Buena Vista, 20 points per game. These are very good basketball players. They're about even when you look at their field goal percentage. Free throw-wise, a little bit of a heavyweight for Jeffries himself. But, I mean, this would be a very good head-to-head comparison tonight that we're going to see on this floor.
Well, you know that. But, again, the interesting thing about the ball game is we well know it's not Shimonitz against Jeffries. It's Wesleyan against Buena Vista. And so both of these young men will be the leaders for their ball club. But the expectation is that they will also be facilitators.
Buena Vista likes to get up and down the court. They like to score. But look at the differential in points allowed. I mean, this is going to be a very much a heated contest up and down the floor. This ought to be a fun one tonight here at Snyder Arena.
Well, that's the expectation, but the disparity I saw there was in rebounding, 42 to about mid-30s for Wesleyan. You got to get the ball off the board. You can't give up not just defensive rebounds, but offensive rebounds, which give additional possessions and, of course, additional points.
We'll find out how things are going to unfold here. Two very good teams to open up conference play here in the American Rivers Conference. Sixth-ranked Nebraska Wesleyan, undefeated Buena Vista. The tip-off is next right here on the Nebraska Wesleyan Sports Network and LNK-TV.
Nebraska Wesleyan University Sports Network presents Prairie Wolves Basketball. Today it's a conference matchup featuring the Beavers of Buena Vista University and your Nebraska Wesleyan.
Side, Kate Schulte for a three.
Look at that.
Shot clock at seven, lining with a runner. Off the glass, the hoop of the horn.
LNKTV Sports and Nebraska Wesleyan University Sports Network presents Prairie Wolves Basketball. Today it's a conference matchup featuring the Beavers of Buena Vista University and your Nebraska Wesleyan University Prairie Wolves. This game is made possible by Lincoln Electric System. It's your electricity, own it. And Nebraska Wesleyan University. Now let's take you out to Snyder Arena with Jeff Motz and John Harris.
And good evening, folks. We welcome you here to Prairie Wolves Basketball on LNK-TV and the Nebraska Wesleyan Sports Network. Once again, I'm Jeff Motz with John Harris as we get you ready for the men's matchup here tonight between Nebraska Wesleyan, number 6 in the D3Hoops.com top 25 rankings, against an undefeated Buena Vista ball club that's under first-year head coach, former Prairie Wolf, and former assistant Wesleyan coach Trevor Johnson. This Buena Vista team was down here last weekend for the Snyder Classic, had an impressive showing, stayed undefeated. They're back here for a second time in about a week.
Well, we hope it's an inauspicious return for Trevor as he comes back to Nebraska Wesleyan. Glad to have him back with a team that is formidable, to say the least. But Coach Wellman, Wesleyan is coming off, you know, two 100-point games, beginning to get their stride. Nate Shimonitz is playing out of his mind, of course. You got to have Hiller and the rest to come on board. But this is going to be a tough game here tonight.
There you see head coach Dale Willman, 117-35 in 6 seasons here at Wesleyan. 2 seasons ago, national champions, 2-time national coach of the year, 3 straight conference titles. He's got the makings of another team that could make another run for a conference championship.
Well, the one thing about Coach Willman, he doesn't recruit guys just to be practice player. Everybody on that bench knows at some point in time, you better be locked and loaded. When you get in the game, you're expected to run, you're expected to shoot, play some team defense, and contribute to this ball club.
Let's look at the head comparisons. When you look at the two top players, there you see Trevor Johnson, the former Prairie Wolf, Lincoln Pius, a 10th graduate, and first-year head coach at Buena Vista, off to an 8-0 start. He scored over 1,000 points here at Wesleyan. But when you look at the head-to-head between these two top players that we're going to see tonight, Nate Shimonitz, again, who averages 25 points a game, he's a senior, and you look at Timothy Jeffries, the other guy for Buena Vista, 20 points per game. These are very good basketball players. They're about even when you look at their field goal percentage. Free throw wise, a little bit of a heavyweight for Jeffries himself, but I mean, this would be a very good head-to-head comparison tonight that we're going to see on this floor.
Well, you know that, but again, the interesting thing about the ball game is we will know it's not Shimonitz against Jeffries, it's Wesleyan against Buena Vista. And so both of these young men will be the leaders for their ball club, but the expectation is that they will also be facilitators.
Buena Vista likes to get up and down the court. They like to score, but look at the differential in points allowed. I mean, this is going to be a very much a heated contest up and down the floor. This ought to be a fun one tonight here at Snyder Arena.
Well, that's the expectation, but the disparity I saw there was in rebounding. 42 to about mid-30s for Wesleyan. You got to get the ball off the board. You can't give up not just defensive rebounds, but offensive rebounds, which give additional possessions and, of course, additional points.
We'll find out how things are going to unfold here. Two very good teams to open up conference play here in the American Rivers Conference. 6th-ranked Nebraska Wesleyan, undefeated Buena Vista. The tip-off is next right here on the Nebraska Wesleyan Sports Network and LNK-TV. Snyder Arena as we get ready to tip things off. Wesleyan in the home whites with the black numerals, black and gold trim. Buena Vista in the road, navy blue with the gold numerals, gold and white trim. Here's the tip controlled by Nebraska Wesleyan. There you see Nate Shimonitz with the basketball to Nate Baugh. High post, right elbow. Here's Dylan Dirks. Now back to Baugh, left side. Man defense here from Buena Vista. Here's Clay Reimers, the former Lincoln East Spartan. Picks up the ball. Here's Jack Hiller. Step back. 15-footer from the free throw line doesn't fall. And the rebound to Buena Vista. This is going to be an up and down type of basketball game, I'm afraid. Again, Buena Vista likes to score. They're averaging in the 90s, Wesleyan in the upper 80s.
Well, the key will be who can play that half-court defense, but also who can rebound.
Here's Jeffries with a floater, missing it, and the rebound to Reimers.
That's a good job by Reimers there.
Here's Hiller out the feet from Szymanets. Door shut, and he is fouled hard underneath the basket. And that foul's going to go against Noah Schmidt, the 6'5 senior forward out of Carlisle, Iowa.
And it was a nice bump with the behind by Schmidt. Knocked Hiller out of Hiller's gotten bigger since he's been at Wesleyan. But Schmidt gave him a nice what for.
Here is Dirks to the basket from the left side, falling to the floor, no whistle, couldn't finish. Back the other way. No look pass to Schmidt, back out Jeffries, three on the way from the right corner, long and air ball. But the offensive board and putback doesn't fall either underneath the basket for Michael Dumars. And now a whistle on the floor, and it will stay with Buena Vista.
Dumars got Reimers tied up after his defensive rebound. Buena Vista keeps the ball and the possession.
Out top, right wing Dumars, three on the way. In and out, off, no good, battle for the ball. Rebound to Dirks. Here comes Szymanets in the front court, averaging 25 points a game, falling to the floor, draws the contact, and a foul gonna go against Buena Vista.
Szymanets is so good at making that contact, initiating the contact, and taking the contact.
Szymanets getting help off the floor from his teammates Dirks and Reimers.
And that's already the second foul on Noah Schmidt.
So he will probably get an early seed here as Szymanets hits the free throw.
Yeah, he's going to be an assistant coach here for quite some time.
And that's big.
That's huge because he's big.
Brendan Gary will check in. He's a junior out of Tucson, Arizona.
6'5", 230.
Free throw from Szymanets is nothing but nylon.
So the press is on.
2-0 start here for Wesleyan, yet they got that pressure, as you alluded to. Now Buena Vista will break it quickly to Jeffries. And now a tie-up and a foul going to go against Wesleyan. I think that's on Szymanets. It is.
Wow.
Lincoln Rock, I think, was the guy that was attacking the basket. It was either him or Dominic Sesma. But Buena Vista will get it right side of the floor on the baseline. And now traveling on Jeffries as he shuffled his feet before he put the ball to the floor.
Looked like one of the Buena Vista running backs there. Jeffries a little anxious here. It's his second attempt at a shot. Got to slow it down.
So ball inbounds to Szymanets. He'll bring it across here for the Prairie Wolves, a 2-0 start. Now when we got a whistle away from the basketball, looks like an offensive foul. Or a turnover.
That's going to be on Nate Baugh.
And on the pick. Nope, Jack Hiller. They're going to give the foul to Hiller.
They're going to give it to Hiller. It looks like, what did I do? He had four fingers up, and then he decided to put a fifth one up.
Sesma with the basketball. High post. Kick out right side. Here's a three from Dumars. Misses it. Offensive board, Jeffries. Good ball movement. Back out to Sesma for a three. Again, doesn't fall. Ball with a rebound. Long outlet near side. Here's Szymanets. Szymanets, skip pass, left corner, Hiller. Double team, needs help. Loose ball. Reimers trying to scramble for it. Still a loose ball. Recovered by Hiller. Out Szymanets. He'll rise up. Three on the way. Off the rim, no good. Battle for the ball underneath. Off of Wesleyan. It will go to Buena Vista.
Yeah, helter-skelter there on the ground. Love the activity by both teams. Somebody's getting a little talking to on the bench over there.
First-year head coach Trevor Johnson.
Already 8-0 with this ball club.
Lincoln roots are deep for him. But this is his first head coaching opportunity at the college level. Sesma.
But boy, what a foundation does he have.
Pull-up jumper, good. Knocks it down.
He was just practicing that very shot, Jeff. The old lean in with the shoulder and step back. He was just practicing that just a few moments ago, and he makes the shot. Practice what you preach, or do what you practice.
Tied at two here. We're about 3 minutes into this first half.
Same offense for Wesleyan. Motion, high post offense.
And Sesma's going to be calling for the reach-in foul. That's his first.
Interesting thing, Trevor Johnson, he knows this offense. He was a part of this offense. He knows exactly what Nebraska Wesleyan wants to do. The problem is, can you stop it?
You see Trevor Johnson right there on your screen. Former Pius X standout as well. Down inside into traffic, Jeffries takes the ball away. But they're going to say that Ball had a hand on it and stepped on the end line.
I mean, he's seen this offense so many times.
And this obviously makes for a good conference rivalry. These are relatively close schools. And a kickball going to be called against Wesleyan because, you know, they're about, what, 3 hours apart from one another. I mean, that's the closest that Wesleyan is to any other school in the conference.
And, boy, what a rivalry it would be. It's a rivalry only if both teams have some balance in terms of who's winning. You know, if one team is dominating the whole thing, that's not a rivalry.
Here's Rock with a crossover to Jeffries. Shot clock at 6. Off the curl, Sesma rising up. Deep three on the way off the back iron right before the shot clock buzzer. Here comes Wesleyan in transition. Nate Baugh. Dirks looking in.
And a mismatch.
Reimers wants the ball. He's going to go to work on the block. Going up to the basket, lays it in.
Oh, that's a Lionel Richie. That's all night long, folks. That's all night long. If they could get it in there to him like that.
4-2 lead here for the Prairie Wolves. Splitting the defense, attacking the basket. The basket will count. And a foul going to go against Wesley. And Brendan Gary taking it to the rack.
Reimers makes a great play on the offensive end and makes a not so much on the defensive end. Sticking that. You got to do better than that. Got to make a better effort defensively than that.
So Reimers picks up the foul. Gary at the line to shoot the one free throw, and he hits it. And that gives Buena Vista a one-point advantage at 5-4. Yes. There's 16 minutes left here in the first half.
Sorry, Jeff. It's 6-7. You know, are you taking the charge? Or are you going for the shot block?
Nice backdoor cut to Baugh, and he was fouled by Jeffries, cutting toward the basket.
What motion. That's a great job. Jeffries was on the back hip. Couldn't do anything about it. And Wesleyan does such a tremendous job rubbing off of those screens. And there he is, wide open. Going to go up with the left hand. Jeffries couldn't do anything but foul him. Send Wesleyan to the line.
Free throw good for Baugh. The senior out of Wood River. There you see Dale Wellman.
He doesn't look stressed at all.
He's
a calm guy.
Calm guy, but there are times if something goes wrong, he'll.
He reminds me of you. I mean, sometimes you get riled up.
Ball hits the second free throw.
But it takes a lot.
It does take a lot.
Take a lot.
6-5, our score. Loose ball. Good defense on the press. Ball got away with a walk. Hiller off the window. Couldn't finish.
Yeah, nobody could grab the ball.
Gary with an underhand pass, driving to the basket, forcing up a shot. Basket counts. Hoop in the harm. It's DJ McNeil off the bench that scores.
Again, back quickly. Wesleyan has to get back in transition defense. Buena Vista does a tremendous job down the baseline. Euro and a nice drop into the basket.
And there you see underneath the basket. Wesleyan faithful and McNeil can't convert on the free throw. Still a one-point advantage here for Buena Vista. Shimonitz on the other end goes toward the basket, but he's fouled.
He just creates so much pressure on the defense. And it looks like Shimonitz, for some reason, I mean, he got him listed as 6'4", but you know, like he continues to get bigger. Maybe it's just his size. Been in the weight room a little bit.
Could be. Baugh pulls up for a three, can't finish it. Ball tipped around, Jeffries comes up with it. Quickly up the floor, near side. Dubmars to the basket, on the drive. Gets it blocked, out of bounds, off of the Prairie Wolves. I don't know if that was Reimers that would be credited for the block or if it was Nate Baugh.
Well, either one, I'd like that. I mean, instead of trying to take a charge, get in there, put your hands in the air. You're 6'7", that makes you about 6'9". Let's see here. I think it was Dirks. Or ball, rather. Ball on the block. I like the rotation.
30-second timeout taken by Nebraska Wesleyan. And, of course, Prairie Wolves basketball here on LNK TV And the Nebraska Wesleyan Sports Network is powered by Lincoln Electric System. There you see Nate Shimonitz, the senior out of Creighton Prep. He's won a state title at Creighton Prep, did so in his senior year in 2016. And they also, a guy like him can add a national championship to his resume.
Boy, did he have a second half in that national championship game?
Oh, boy, he was
did
so
Did he have a second
pivotal.
Half? Oh, my goodness. Boy, he was lights out.
Not very many guys can say they won a state title in basketball in high school and a national championship in the college level, but he can. Entry pass taken away by Wesleyan. Reimers comes up with it. Hiller lost the dribble. And the loose ball picked up by Buena Vista in officials timeout. We got a warning. The officials have issued a warning. I mean, there's some talking going on.
That was a flop warning.
Oh, a flop warning. That's what, all right, so a flop warning.
Oh, my goodness.
I think that's the first time I've ever seen that
call.
Yeah,
they're trying to get that out of the ball game, trying to get that out of sports.
And a kick ball in that 3-2 zone from Wesleyan.
That used to be where, you know, particularly on the offensive end, if a guy would shoot the ball and he'd kick his feet out, you know, trying to initiate the contact and make the referee make a call. They're trying to say that that's unsportsmanlike nowadays.
Here's a three from Sesma, and he knocks it through.
Boy, I tell you what, right there at the top of the key. You got to rotate better if you're Wesleyan.
So the Prairie Wolves find themselves down here on their home court, 10-6. Inside, Hiller going to work off the window and through.
Nice job posting up by Jack Hiller, and they're back the other way quickly.
Wesleyan, by the way, 0-for-2 from three-point range. Right side, here's McNeil for a three. Can't go. Back the other way. Cordell Gillingham is into the game. And he turns the ball over. He called for traveling.
Well, I didn't see him move his foot, Jeff.
So Gillingham turns the ball over.
Yeah, Wesleyan wants to be careful. You don't want to have empty trips against a ball club like this.
No, this is a very dangerous basketball team.
Yeah, you don't want to have those little unforced turnovers nonetheless.
High post, Gary back out, Sesma. He wants to take the three.
Yeah, he does, a step back.
Here's Jeffries, left wing. Pulls up, Sesma.
Nice recovery by Dirks.
He'll take the three with a hand in his face. In and out, no good. Rebound, Reimers, and a foul on the rebound against Buena Vista.
Reimers is going to have a 20-rebound game here tonight because those long shots, as they carry them off, you have the opportunity. And he's the tallest guy out there. Wesleyan, you know, they're playing basically with four guards and a forward. And Reimers is going to have to do a tremendous job.
And when we got a hand check against Buena Vista, it's Lincoln Rock going to be called for the foul.
Yeah, listen, that's a mismatch. That's like me and Denzel watching in a handsome contest. There's no contest. He's going to lose. Okay. Shimonitz has that upper body strength. He's savvy. The so forth Rock is just out of his league there. Again, not that he's a lesser player, but Shimonitz is just a bigger guy.
Shimonitz connects on the first free throw. He's yet to hit a field goal tonight. Second free throw.
And he finds himself in mismatches like that all the time. The great thing about it is he takes advantage of it.
All 4 points from the charity stripe. We're deadlocked at 10. Just over 13 minutes remaining. As you see on your screen, another kick basketball off the foot of Dylan Dirks.
Yeah, we've seen a lot of these kind of lazy passes from both teams.
Austin Hall comes in for Wesleyan.
And the thing about Wesleyan, when you come off that bench, you know, you're expected to be a contributor. Okay, you got to be ready, locked and loaded, ready to shoot, ready to play some tough defense.
Lincoln Rock in the lane. Here's a floater from Gary. Got it to go.
Yeah, nice job on the interior there. And a nice float in to the basket by Brendan Gary.
12-10, Buena Vista. Here's Gillingham to Shimonitz. Here's Reimers on the right side. Now to Hall. Reimers wide open, three on the way. Got it.
Boy, that's nice. That's nice. Locked and loaded. Release, rotation, splash.
And the Prairie Wolves back in control by one.
Buena Vista's looking for spaces. Spaces.
They're trying to exploit that 3-2. McNeil, 15-footer, bounces around and off. No good. Loose ball. Reimers keeps it alive. Now to Shimonitz. Shimonitz to the other end. Finger rolling through.
Oh, boy. Look at that. Now get back on defense.
The lead at 3, 15-12. 12 minutes left here, first half. Trying to tie this one up is Buena Vista. Here's a 3 from the right wing. Off the iron, no good. That time taken by Garrett Sittner. On the other end, here is Hiller to the basket, goes up, got a block, but Reimers fouls it up and puts it in.
That's the old look what I found. Nice look up by Shimonitz.
17-12, 7-0 run here for Wesleyan. Sittner, entry pass to Gary, taken away by Reimers. Wow, is he having a heck of a first half or what?
Got to keep that up, though.
Shimonitz on the other end pulls up, mid-range jumper off, no good. Rebound to Gary.
Yeah, needed a couple of more dribbles there. Pulled up a little bit too early there, Shimonitz.
Here's McNeil, left wing rock.
McNeil's threatening that long-range shot.
McNeil, 3 on the way. Oh, man, that was pretty.
No threat that time. He splashed it from downtown.
That's 5 for him, and that pulls Buena Vista within 2. 11 minutes to go here before halftime. Number 6 Prairie Wolves here on their home court being tested tonight. Here's Hiller. He'll rise up for a 3 off. And the rebound, it goes to Lincoln Rock.
You can't get any bad fouls on the defensive rebound there.
Jeffries is going to take it. No, he'll kick out in the corner. Sittner, 3 on the way. Oh, mercy!
He almost hit the court up there. Nice job.
Wow. And just like that, a 6-0 response here for Buena Vista. 10.5 and counting. And the backdoor entry pass is thrown away, and Hiller says he got bumped up.
He got held is what happened.
And no whistle. And Shimonitz is talking to one of the officials, too. So is Dale Wellman.
Yeah, they're holding, and they're not calling it. But, hey, you know, is it holding if they don't call it? So Wellman's doing as much politicking as I think I've ever seen him do.
He's really lobbying over there, isn't he?
Yeah, he's asking the far side ref here to keep his eyes open. That's a kick ball.
No whistle. Left wing, Sittner, wide open, 3 on the way. Long, an air ball goes out of bounds off of Dirks. And it will stay with Buena Vista.
Sittner from Adams Central.
From Junietta. Right outside the Hastings area in Adams County. So he is a native Nebraskan on that roster for Buena Vista.
Yeah, why not?
Here's a 3 from Sesma. Long, an air ball, out of bounds.
Well, that ain't going to stop him from shooting. I'll tell you what, Sesma, one just awry, just off the side there.
10 minutes exactly to go here before halftime.
Time's moving quickly.
And this is a very tight ball game. Here's Gillingham at the top. Crossover, picks up the dribble. Looking for a backdoor bounce pass. Ball lost it. Recovered by Hall. Short-armed it. Missed it. Got his own rebound, but lost the ball.
Oh, he had one point blank there, Jeff.
Here's Sesma to the other end. A floater on the way. No good. And an offensive foul.
I don't know if the other ref was going to call that. He was going to call blocking.
Well, it looked like he was out of control.
And he was. But they had two different. Look at the top ref up there. I don't think he's going to call a block. But the inside ref calls the offensive foul. They were going to call a block. So one ruled out. Wesleyan down one.
18-17 Buena Vista. They're keeping this thing interesting. Again, they're undefeated. Coming into the conference opener tonight, here's Baugh, backs his way in on Jeffries. Baugh, turnaround shot, forced up, got it blocked. No, they're going to say a foul.
Whoa.
That looked like a clean block at Jeffries.
Baseline ref didn't call it.
Jeffries commits his second foul.
Yeah, don't know about that one.
It looked like a clean block from where we were.
Yeah, he was right there playing tough defense. Maybe.
Free throw up and in for Nate Baugh.
Maybe.
It's three for him.
But the ref on the baseline was right there. The far ref way out. Past the three-point line, called a foul. You don't expect that.
Second free throw for Baugh up and in.
Wesleyan, 100% from the free throw line.
That's
what you should be in your own gym.
3-2 zone.
And again, Buena Vista is looking for space.
Far corner, here's a three on the way, and it's off. No good that time for Dumars. And here comes Dylan Dirks behind the back dribble. Down to the front court, Shimonitz. Under 9 to go here before halftime. A tight ball game here in the conference opener at Snyder Arena. Dirks forcing a shot up, and he's called for traveling.
Yeah, what are you doing? What are you doing?
He was trying to draw the contact.
Yeah, what are you going? Where are you going? What are you doing? That's out of character and outside the offense. You might want to come and become assistant coach. You're freelancing there.
So Jack Hiller will check in the next dead ball. McNeil at the top.
Better keep a hand up.
And an entry pass denied by Reimers. Here's Hall on the break. Hall fakes it, goes up, misses it. He short-armed the layup.
Second time he short-armed it. He'll shoot it.
Here's McNeil for a three. Oh, he missed it. Back the other way. Here's Dirks off the rebound.
Second time Hall is not elevated.
Here is Reimers. Dirks for a three, in and out. Offensive board for Baugh, the putback.
No block out for Buena Vista. Baugh sneaks right inside for the offensive putback.
21-18, Wesleyan. Good ball movement. Three from Rock with the left hand. High arcing shot, bounces off, no good. Shimonitz with the rebound. And he is going to collide with Gary in transition, and Gary's going to be called for the foul. That's his first. That is team foul number 10.
This guy is so strong. My goodness. He just grabs the ball. Here he goes. He's moving. You're not going to get a call there.
So double bonus here for Nate Shimonitz, who's got 6 points in this game tonight. Free throw is good. Make it seven.
And free throws will be such an important part of this ball game, as these teams are very evenly matched. Wesleyan 9 of 9 thus far. See if he can make it 10 of 10.
Hits it.
And there it is.
23-18, Wesleyan by 5.
A little bit of a disparity. Buena Vista's only taken 2 free throws. They've made 1 out of 2.
Here's McNeil inside. Gary out here to Sittner. Now to McNeil for a long three, and he rattles it through.
That's a great job by McNeil. Taking advantage.
That's 8 off the bench for him. On the other end, a layup for Shimonitz.
The whirling dervish there.
He's got 10.
That's instant offense right there. And Coach Johnson is like, I know that guy.
Here's McNeil. Crossover kick out, Rock far corner. Here's a three, got it.
Oh, Lincoln Rock. That's a nice job by McNeil. The drive, the draw, the dish, the tray.
25-24, Prairie Wolves. Early offense here. Hiller to Reimers. He'll take the three off. Tipped around, loose ball. Hiller gets it. Back in the hands of Baugh. Alley-oop to Reimers with a two-hand flush.
Nice job there on the scramble. Throws it up. He throws it down.
What a play. A broken play offensively results in something good. Ball knocked away by Dirks. Shot clock at 10 for Buena Vista. Long three from McNeil off the back iron, but Gary keeps it alive.
That's what those long shots will do.
Here's a floater from McNeil. Got it.
Well, that's nice by DJ McNeil.
He's got 10 off the bench, and he's become the thorn in the side of the Prairie Wolves.
He's aggressive. That's what's key. Tremendous job of being aggressive, making the shots that he can make.
And timeout going to be called by Nebraska Wesleyan. With 5:43 to go here before halftime, the Prairie Wolves are up by one, 27-26. Snyder Arena is where we're at tonight here on LNK TV. Look at the second chance points so far in this first half. 6-2 in favor of Wesleyan. They've been very aggressive at close range at the basket. Shimonitz kick out. Reimer's three on the way off. No good. The rebound to McNeil.
Yeah, way off the other side. Nice look.
Here's Rock in transition for a three. Short. Reimer's with a rebound.
Give it up. Give it up.
Up the floor. Gets it to Hiller in the front court. They'll slow it down, set up an offense.
In a size mismatch Shimonitz has on McNeil.
What about Reimers? Reimers.
Surprised they didn't want to post him up.
I would have done that. Shimonitz for a long three. Off the iron, no good. Tipped around. Ball gets the ball. Keeps it alive. New shot clock. Here's a three on the way from Peyton Priest, who can't convert, and the rebound to Buena Vista.
Boy, an opportunity there. Boy, missed by Wesleyan.
Left side, here's a three on the way from Sittner off the iron. Ball tipped around. Priest comes up with the basketball. And now Wesleyan in the front court.
Always critical what happens with those 50-50 balls.
Out of the high post, Baugh. Looking for cutters. Shot clock at 13. Lost the ball.
And that's not what you want if you're Wesleyan.
McNeil wide open, three on the way, in and out, no good. Reimers or Hiller going after the rebound, but it was last touched out of bounds off of Buena Vista.
And Coach Johnson, I mean, he's locked and loaded. McNeil is locked and loaded. He's got the green light. So this is nip and tuck right here. I mean, a rebound here, a loose ball there.
4 minute mark approaching here in the first half. Shimonitz on the low block, double team, forcing his way up. Fadeaway shot, no good. Reimers offensive board goes back up, too strong with it, and the rebound, it goes to Buena Vista.
Yeah, you got to close the deal on that one if you're Reimers.
And now Shimonitz is going to be called for a reach-in foul. That's number two.
Yeah, that's a no-no. That's a no-no. A bad foul. And he just wanted an opportunity to talk to the ref. Yeah, get another opportunity. Don't make a bad foul. I mean, this game is too important. It can be too close. Now you got to go out of the game here. 3:51 in the second, in the half here, and a long shot from the corner.
Long and air ball for Sittner, and a tie up for the ball. And Reimers is going to be called for the foul. That's his second.
Oh my goodness. Well, you know what? I'm going to give credit to Buena Vista on that one, because Reimers is holding the ball, and he comes in and he just muscles it away from him. So Reimers is going to become an assistant coach, taking the height out of the offense and defense. And so give credit to the Beavers for just some weight room action there.
McNeil to the basket, lays it in.
I like the shield with the off arm.
He is having a heck of a game off the bench.
I like his confidence. 12 points for McNeil.
Here's Austin Hall with the left hand and lays it in.
You missed too easy one, makes the tough one. Now you got to get back.
Here's a ball that gets away, knocked out of bounds, last touched by Buena Vista.
And Coach Johnson's like, what are you doing? What are you doing? Use your head. Use your head.
29-28, Prairie Wolves with the lead in the ball. Cordell Gillingham in the high post. Baugh looking for cutters out. Gillingham, no, an offensive foul on the screen. And timeout going to be called by Nebraska Wesleyan with 3:11 to go here before halftime. The Prairie Wolves clinging to a one-point advantage here at Snyder Arena. Across the way, there's the voice of the Prairie Wolves on KFOR, FM 103.3, 1240 AM, Dick Janda. And Nebraska Wesleyan wide receiver, the senior, Derek Curtis.
Does he look involved or what? Wake up, Derek.
Can't be dull at this game. I mean, so they're doing the game on the radio tonight on KFOR here in Lincoln. By the way, you and I were doing high school basketball on KFOR tomorrow night.
Tomorrow night.
East and Southeast.
First game, locked and loaded, ready to go.
Look at the bench points. Buena Vista outscoring Wesleyan off the bench 20-2.
And give most of that to McNeil.
Yeah,
because he's coming in like gangbusters.
He's got 12 of those 20 points.
He's coming in like gangbusters. Made a bad decision on that last possession, running a little bit too fast. Now Sesma's back in the ball game.
He's a threat. Ball tipped up. Good defense from the Prairie Wolves. Baugh up the floor. Hall lays it up, and he got it blocked. Gillingham with a follow-up and puts it in.
Oh, and
Hall went down hard.
He's like, what happened?
I mean, he got hit hard and no whistle.
Well, let's see if payback. I mean, he got really racked. Wesleyan still gets the basket.
Senior out of Millard West, Austin Hall.
And his right hip, upper leg area. Be careful there. Both of these guys can bang it from downtown.
McNeil for a three, short and air ball. Jeffries tracks it down, but he went out of bounds with it.
Jeffries has not been in the ball game for a while, as Sesma hasn't been in the ball game.
Well, Jeffries has got two fouls.
Sesma, I think, has two as well.
And he has yet to score. Here's Hall. Out on the perimeter, left side ball. Now Dirks. Hall into the corner. Whole new lineup except for Dylan Dirks. Hall lost the ball on a steal. Sesma to the other end. Goes up. Altered his layup. Put it in.
Yeah, too much dribbling from Hall.
That's seven for Sesma.
And Sesma makes him pay on the turnover. Great job by Buena Vista.
2 minutes to go here before halftime. 31-30 lead here for Wesleyan. Dirks in the high post. Here's Baugh. Trying to reset the offense here. Shot clock at seven. Spin move. Lost the ball and a turnover.
In tight quarters there. Great job of defense by the Beavers.
You bet.
Nice opportunity to The
ball goes out of bounds. Buena Vista could not take advantage of the turnover, and they turn the ball over.
Yeah, they don't capitalize there. And Wesleyan just trying to weather the storm with Schimmenitz and Reimers on the bench along with Hiller. All three with three fouls. I mean, with two fouls, rather.
Here's Hall. Kick out right corner. Gillingham, three, missing it. Tipped out. Recovered by Hall. Altered his shot. Fell to the floor. No whistle. Time for the basketball. What do we got here? A foul. It's on Nate Baugh. And now we'll go to the other end for the 1-1.
Boy, West.
Austin Hall has just been pinballed around close to the basket tonight.
He's going to need a cold bath, a hot bath, a warm bath, some Epsom salts, some Bengay.
Icy hot.
He's going to need it all, you know.
Here comes the former Pius X standout, Thomas Robertson, into the game for Wesleyan. And there you see the Delta boys underneath the hoop. I call them the Deltas. Jeffries at the line to shoot the 1-1. Hits it.
Nice job by Jeffries. If I'm not mistaken, didn't he have a brother on the team a year ago?
I believe so.
Yeah, trying
but
to.
This is his first point of the game, and it comes with a minute 14 left before halftime.
Which bodes well for Buena Vista. He's the leading scorer. He's got his first 2 points.
So he converts on the bonus. And that gives Buena Vista a one-point advantage here with a minute 14 to go before halftime.
And so you get Jeffries back on the floor. He gets his first 2 points. He's going to sit out this last minute 14 going into the half.
Here's Dirks, gives it up to Baugh. Robertson with the basketball, needing help. Goes to Baugh on the baseline, double team. Lost the ball, shot clock at 12. Under a minute to go here. Dirks, left wing, Baugh. Baugh, spin move, pulls up and under move, shot on the way, off the glass.
Oh, that was nice. Now 43 seconds. Wesleyan up one.
33-32. Shot clock still on. There's about a 13-second differential. Ball knocked away. Loose ball picked up by Baugh. Good defense by Wesleyan. No-look pass. Gillingham reverse up and in.
Nice job on the break. Probably the last possession here.
35-32. Some big baskets here in the final seconds of this first half.
And Wesleyan has to just get to watch the gaps, and that's what the Beavers are looking for. Where's the gap?
Down to five. Here's a floater from McNeil. Rims off, no good. Around to Rock, who throws the ball up in the air behind his head, and time runs out, and the Prairie Wolves are holding on desperately to a 35-32 halftime lead over Buena Vista. What a first half of basketball, and we're not even remotely close to being done with this one here at Snyder Arena. We're at the break. Your score, Nebraska Wesleyan 35, Buena Vista 32. Back with more in just a moment on the Nebraska Wesleyan Sports Network and LNK TV.
What powers Lincoln? Well, for starters, many of you. LES is a not-for-profit, customer-owned electric utility, a public power company proudly employing more than 500 community members. It doesn't get much more local than that. But how do our family members, friends, and neighbors deliver that highly reliable, entirely public power to our homes and businesses? It starts with generation, by way of coal-fired power plants, natural gas turbines, and innovative renewable energy sources like methane, water, wind, and even solar power. This balance.
When you are in the market for a truck, car, SUV.
What powers Lincoln? Well, for starters, many of you. LES is a not-for-profit, customer-owned electric utility, a public power company proudly employing more than 500 community members. It doesn't get much more local than that. But how do our family members, friends, and neighbors deliver that highly reliable, entirely public power to our homes and businesses? It starts with generation, by way of coal-fired power plants, natural gas turbines, and innovative renewable energy sources like methane, water, wind, and even solar power. This balance of resources generates the energy that powers our everyday. Transmission lines act as electricity's trusted middleman. 300 miles of these high-voltage lines stream reliable power to substations throughout the Lincoln area. Substations decrease electricity's voltage, preparing it for distribution within a local region. Before delivery, voltage is decreased once more for safe usage in our homes and businesses. Our modern-day electrical grid allows LES to more accurately monitor demand, increase reliability, and keep costs low for the communities we serve. And now, the next time you plug in, tune in, and charge up. Your connection will have a stronger tie to local communities that power one another. Stay current with all things LES online and on social.
You're watching Prairie Wolves basketball on LNK TV Sports and the Nebraska Wesleyan University Sports Network.
Welcome back to Snyder Arena here on LNK TV and the Nebraska Wesleyan Sports Network. Jeff Motes and John Harris with you here at Snyder Arena. And again, a very interesting basketball game. We're not seeing a lot of major scoring runs taking place, John. It's been very close. I think the biggest lead we've seen at one point was probably 5 or 6 points. But let's look at the first half stats here. When you compare these two teams, we'll get that graphic up there for you. There you see the shooting percentage. Wesleyan much better shooting at 37%. And then Buena Vista at 33%. Look at the three-point differential. Wesleyan's only hit 1 out of 10 three-point attempts.
Wow.
5 of 24. That, I mean, look
24
how
shots.
Look
wow.
how much they're taking from the perimeter. But the difference too is this: the free throws. Wesleyan 10 of 10, 3 of 4 for Buena Vista. The turnovers are dead even, but the rebounding advantage to Wesleyan. And again, Nate Shimonis, the top scorer for this Wesleyan program, 25 points per game. He's only got 10 points.
Well. He's going to come on in the second half. The key for me, as I look there, are the rebounding. 10 and 10 in terms of turnovers, but the rebounding was going to be key. I said earlier that Reimers needed to have a huge rebounding game. He did until such time as he had to leave the game. But Shimonis is going to come back. He's going to be strong. The interesting thing for Buena Vista is that Jeffries only has 2 points, and
yeah.
they're only 3 points down. So that bodes well for them. So I'm sure he's going to pick it up in the second half.
Look at the points, the paint. Wesleyan with 22 in the lane versus 10 from Buena Vista.
And could have more if Paul could have gotten two of it, three or four of his easy pointy bunnies to go in.
Well, Buena Vista, they're going to go, looks like, with their same starters. Remember, too, Noah Schmidt, he had been sitting on the bench for much of the first half.
Boy, he went out early.
And there he is, number 42 there with the mustache there. He's the guy that provides a little bit of a physical presence. He came out early because of those two early fouls. He's got to stay clean if he wants to keep a presence in there for Buena Vista, especially at certain times when they need a physical presence close to the basket.
And that's why Reimers probably got as many rebounds as he did, because Schmidt wasn't in there. But give credit to McNeil, who really came up and stepped up big time. 12 huge points in that first half. McNeil comes in off the bench and shows himself to be an offensive threat, big time, with 12 big points.
So Wesleyan here up 35-32.
And they also have three players, Hiller, Shimonis, and Reimers, with 2 fouls. And so the next foul on either of those guys will be significant. And you can believe that Trevor Johnson has alerted his team that is the case.
Yeah.
And if you can get Shimonis in the foul trouble, boy, I'll tell you what, that's going to be a problem for Wesleyan.
You can't afford to lose him to fouls early on in the second half. He's got to try to play it clean. Prairie Wolves with the basketball, trying to go with a high-low. Here's Reimers on a low block going to work against Schmidt. Turn around, off the window, no good. Gets his own rebound. Lost the ball, out of bounds, off of Wesley, and he'll go to Buena Vista.
Boy, he needed to go up with the left hand. He has a layup and a deuce. If he goes up with the left hand, he goes in with the right hand instead and gets the miss. He did pad his stats with an additional offensive rebound.
So here is Sesma. And there's a shot from Detmers that was partially blocked there, I think, by Reimers. And now on the other end of transition, the ball tipped out of bounds off of Buena Vista. It will stay with Wesleyan.
So again, two empty trips here, an empty trip by each to start the ball game here in the second half.
35-32 again. Dirks from the top for a three, and he knocks it down.
Boy, that's a big shot by Dylan Dirks. He did a little bit too much dribbling in that first half.
38-32. Nice feed from Schmidt to Jeffries off the window and through.
Could have been an and one as well. Nice pass.
First field goal of the game for Jeffries. He's got four.
A nice utilization of Schmidt on that possession as well.
There's Dirks in the post. Schimonitz going to work, backing his way and turn around. Shot, misses it, but he's fouled.
And Rock is trying to figure out what am I going to do with this guy? What am I going to do with this guy? You got 6'1", 175 on 6'4", 210. Again, a mismatch that you have to recognize.
Free throw from Schimonitz bounces through, and so the Prairie Wolves are 11 of 11 from the free throw line tonight.
They're going to have to be 30 of 30 if they're going to win the game because you can't miss anything with this team. Whatever opening you leave, there it is right there.
There's the first miss.
Yeah, whatever opening you leave, they're going to take advantage of it. McNeil, again, he can splash it from right there. So you better get your hand. You better extend that defense.
McNeil out left side, Detmers. In the corner it goes to Jefferson, out of Schmidt. Here's a one-hander in the lane, and he got it to go. The first basket of the game for Noah Schmidt.
Yeah, a little Big Dipper action right there. Got the tight end body, but nice touch inside. Hiller's going to have to come on in the second half, Jeff.
He's been absolutely quiet. Hiller has only got, by my count, 3 points. Here's Dirks, shot clock at 8. Reimers for a three, short. Offensive board, Dirks, shot clock resets to 20. So they'll reset and try to run an offense.
Yeah, Wesleyan now with the offensive rebounds.
Schimonitz lost the ball, gets tied up with it. Loose ball picked up by Reimers. Bounce pass inside to Hiller, lays it in.
Oh, the old look what I found, 50-50. Wesleyan benefits again. Last time they got a dunk on the alley-oop off the scramble.
41-36. Here's a three from Lincoln Rock. Missing that one, no good. Rescued by McNeil, but not in time as it goes out of bounds.
Yeah, Rock, a nice hoist and heave on that one. Didn't look too smooth.
That's actually 4 points for Hiller. I beg your pardon, I had three. It's actually four instead of five.
Another empty trip for Buena Vista.
Here's Dirks at the top. Here's Reimers off the screen dribbling. And what do we got, an offensive foul? Looks like a moving screen. Dylan Dirks picks up the foul. 41-36. These teams, again, Buena Vista averaging low 90s per game. Wesleyan in the upper 80s. Both teams allow about 73 points a game, too. Rock, kick out, Jeffrey, shot fake, dribble drive. Crossover goes up, rejected by Reimers, out of bounds.
And that's what he has to be able to do. Great job by Reimers to come over and be the enforcer there. Get out of here with that, with the left hand.
McNeil, shot fake and a dribble, falls to the floor, kept it alive. Here's Rock with 7. Into the corner, Jeffries. Dribbling around, going up. Ball stripped out of his hands. McNeil recovers, shot clock at 1, shot up, no good. They're going to wave it off. Shot clock violation. It was awfully close. It looked like it may have left his hand right before The clock went off.
Yeah, too many empty trips here early for Buena Vista.
Still a five-point lead here for the Prairie Wolves. 16 minutes, 30 seconds left. Here is Hiller down low, missing it on the turnaround. Wasn't totally squared up on the turnaround shot. And now a transition. Hiller takes the ball away. Shimonitz to the other end, runs into Jeffries. No, they're going to wave it off, but he's fouled. I thought he got continuation, but Jeffries picks up his third foul.
Not the NBA here, but he's got a head of steam. Here he comes. Yeah. But that's a big foul on Jeffries.
Now timeout going to be called by Buena Vista with 16:14 remaining in this game. Wesleyan, and now Dale Wellman out there talking with the official about the continuation. And he's doing all he can to get his team really pumped up too.
He's done everything but put out yard signs for all the politicking that he's doing. But I'll tell you what. But you know, though, that might bode well for him later to get a call. Or to get the referee's eye focused on something. But when you got Shimonitz coming downhill, I mean, what are you going to do?
Yeah.
I mean, that puts the defense at a tremendous disadvantage. Everybody's running back. And so the question is, was he in motion as Jeffries fouled him? Wellman says yes. Trevor says no. Trevor Johnson says no.
Now, this is.
And so that what that means is that he doesn't go through the free throw line. So, again, ball out of bounds. They play some tough defense. They'll get a turnover.
And now Jeffries just picked up his fourth foul.
And he's going to have to sit out.
He's going to have to sit down. And he is still arguing with the officials.
He bumped him. So he's going to be sitting out for quite some time.
Yeah.
Well, that's huge. Mark that, 16-13, Jeffries goes out.
Dirks misses the three, and it goes out of bounds. And there you see Jeffries taking a seat on the bench for Buena Vista.
Well, I mean, he played sparingly in that first half, and they played well, so they'll have to do that here.
Good ball movement here. Brendan Gary is back into the game. Ball knocked away. Shimonitz, loose ball. Shimonitz picks it up, lays it in.
Yeah, not a kick ball because it went off the shin. Shimonitz.
Now, Trevor Johnson thought it went off his foot. Entry pass in the post, taken away. Here come the Prairie Wolves. Hiller across the timeline trying to protect the ball. Shimonitz in the corner. Ball wide open, three on the way. In and out, no good. And the rebound to Gary as they collide underneath. Gary and Dirks collide underneath the basket. And a foul going to go against Dylan Dirks. That's number three on him.
Yeah, Dirks just in there battling, as he often is. Need a towel down that baseline. I don't know if you saw the video of Juwan Howard a couple of games ago going down on hands and knees to wipe the floor of perspiration.
I'm trying to remember which game that was.
Yeah.
It's been like in the last week or so.
Yeah. Leaders lead by do what I do, not just what I say.
Inside Schmidt, cutting across the lane.
Oh, right, double dribble.
No call there. They'll let them play. Good defense from Wesley, and here's Rock. He'll pull up with a left-handed floater, and the rebound goes to Hiller. The ball knocked out of his hands by Rock. It will stay with Wesley.
That's the second time that a Beaver has pulled the ball away from a Prairie Wolf. And, again, you got to secure the ball. Happened to Reimers at first time. That time, though, it doesn't benefit the Beavers offensively. You got to secure the rebound. And again, you got to watch it here if you're Rock.
Shimonitz to the basket, blazing in.
That's a mismatch there.
That's all day for Shimonitz.
Like Jeff Motzen, Russell Krona, good-looking contest, no contest.
Far from it.
Russell doesn't have a chance.
Far from it. Here's McNeil.
Well, be careful there if you hit her.
Three from Dutmars, doesn't fall. The rebound to Ball.
Glad he kept his pivot foot. Here we go.
Reimers, left corner, Gillingham, three on the way, hits it.
Oh, boy, going to watch it here.
And this thing has just opened up to a double-digit lead for the Prairie Wolves. And I think Trevor Johnson at some point better take a timeout.
No, he's thinking. You got to watch this possession here.
McNeil on a runner, in and out, no good. Rebound to Baugh. Bet you the next time they get the ball, he'll burn a timeout. Reimers, offensive foul.
Oh, my goodness. He's moving.
Offensive foul on Reimers.
He's moving. You cannot call that. He's moving.
And Dale Willman is telling the official the same thing.
Oh, yeah, you can't. No,
he was not set.
Oh, my goodness. You can't do that. You cannot call that.
And Dale Willman not happy about that. And the Wesleyan faithful here at Snyder Arena giving the officials the business.
Well, he needs an earful. I mean, that's terrible. He's got a head of steam. The defender is moving.
Gary forcing up a shot, double dribble. No, they're going to call it traveling.
We'll make up action there.
Well, if there was an opportune time for Buena Vista to try to turn things around, it was that possession because it was coming off a controversial call. Shimonet's eye off the glass and in.
Uh-oh, steal.
And a steal by Hiller. Three on the way from him. Off, no good. Rebound, Shimonet's. No, loose ball. Collision in front of the Wesleyan bench, and the ball goes out of bounds.
Oh, boy, that would have been a killer three-point shot for Hiller. I didn't mean that to rhyme, folks, but it works out that way sometimes.
Buena Vista has been in a scoring drought for the past 5 minutes. They have not scored in 5 minutes, and Wesleyan has taken control up by 14 now.
Look like you got guys in the ballgame right now that are not their main guys.
Here's Gary missing it, too strong on the runner.
Boy, they're just missing in tight, all close, but not going down.
Shimonets with the basketball, 13 minutes left in this one. Here is Reimers. Hiller to Gillingham on the far side. Shimonets off the curl, three on the way, nothing but nylon.
Oh, the rainbow. Have you ever seen a rainbow?
He is on fire.
And I tell you, we knew the second half he was going to show up. Don't want to back up too far from Sesma there.
Prairie Wolves in the midst of a 14-0 run here. Drive to the hoop, layup doesn't fall, offensive board and put back, and the hoop of the harm, the stick back. Michael Detmars gets the basket, his first points of the game.
And the third foul on Jack Hiller. Nice contest there now.
And the
Mars there gets it on the offensive glass, and that's why the offensive rebound is so important. You get more possessions, more opportunities to score. DeMars does a tremendous job there on the glass.
Hometown kid from Storm Lake out of St. Mary's High School converts on the three-point play, and that ends the 14-0 run for Wesleyan.
And Jeffrey's back in the ball game with four fouls, Jeff, at 12:29.
So now a little bit of pressure in the backcourt from Buena Vista. And here is Nate Ball with the ball across the timeline. Goes to Shimonets coming out from the high post. Facing up. He'll drive to the basket. Lost the ball and a foul. They're going to call the foul, I think, on Lincoln Rock. I thought Shimonets just lost the ball trying to go up.
Lincoln Rock has the toughest job in Lincoln tonight. You know, there are a lot of people doing a lot of tough jobs. But Lincoln Rock has a tough job. If his job is trying to stop Nate Shimonets, slow him down, it ain't happening. It's not happening.
Gillingham thought about it. Baugh going to work the dribble.
Oh, watch it.
Pick and roll. Baugh lost it, recovers it. Shot clock at 8. Down to 7. Shot on the way from Baugh. Pump. That time doesn't fall. Tipped around. Loose ball. Sesma comes up with it. He'll pull up for a 15-footer, and he buries it.
Good to have him. I'm sure they're glad to have him back on the floor. That's making baskets. Wesleyan had a chance there.
They need him big time. That's 9 for Sesma. 53-41. And Shimonets, and a blocking foul.
Oh, is that on Jeffries?
You got to be kidding me.
It is.
It's on Jeffries. That is number 5 on Timothy Jeffries.
Let's see what happens here.
Oh, boy.
He was leaning a little bit, but he was standing there. Shimonich just went sideways right past him, and Jeffries has an early exit here. 11. And I thought it might have been a challenging thing to put him back in the ballgame so early. But he's done for the night.
That's huge.
With 4 points in 17 minutes.
That's huge.
Had a brother David on the team a year ago.
Actually, to 2016, he was a defensive player of the year in the American Rivers Conference as Shimonich hits the free throw.
Yeah, I remember because they're from Nevada. Las Vegas.
North Las Vegas is where they're from.
Yeah, had two guys named Jeffries from Las Vegas. Maybe they were related. And they were.
Shimonich connects on the free throw.
Wesley in 13 of 14 from the free throw line.
Shimonich with 22 points in the game, too. Inside Gary. Ball tipped up, taken away by Shimonich. On the move, lob to Hiller, and now we got a collision, an offensive foul on Shimonich. Guess what? That's number 4 on him, I believe, or 3. That's 3.
Yeah, you can't jump in the air. Can't jump in the up. That's a great job by Gary. Great job by Brendan Gary of standing his ground and putting himself in a position to take one for the team. That may be the big play of the ball game if this comes down to the stretch. That might be the play right there.
Well, he's being looked at by the trainer right now. He might have banged his knee on the opposing player. Rock saves the ball from going out of bounds, but into the hands of Dirks. Dirks going to the other end, lays it up. Too strong, no good. Battle for the ball underneath with Hiller. Goes out of bounds off of Hiller. It will go with Buena Vista. 11:04 to go in this ball game. The lead at 14 for Wesleyan.
Another close miss for Wesleyan. Again, Reimer's back in the ball game to dominate the glass. He needs to do that. Buena Vista looking for gaps, looking for spaces.
Gary in the lane, good.
And that's what it's all about right there. That's beautiful.
7 for Brendan Gary off the bench.
And that zone defense, you just have to find the gap, find the space, and find somebody who can close and finish. Gary does it there quickly.
Here's Austin Hall, now to Reimers. Inside they go, Gillingham on the low block, turnaround, good.
Muscles, upper body right there.
6'2 at 200, a senior out of Greeley, Colorado, Cordell Gillingham.
Yes, there it is again for Gary.
Out left side for Lincoln Rock, and he buries it.
And this is the time where Buena Vista says, hey, listen, we will not go quietly.
Now within 11, 57-46. Boy, this has been a very good ball game.
Oh, great game.
Despite what the point margin is right now. And a foul going to go against Sesma.
Yeah, just started to body him just a little bit.
So that's team foul number 6 here in the half against Buena Vista.
So Sesma's going to become an assistant coach there for a little bit. McNeil, no slouch, by the way, folks. He had 12 points in that first half. Like, world be free.
Hiller. Here is Gillingham for a 3 with a hand in his face. He couldn't convert. Now Gary will go from one end to the other, forcing up a shot.
Whoa.
He draws a blocking foul on Gillingham.
Whoa. Tough calls, man. I'll tell you what, and that's always the toughest call. Hey, we slid over at that last moment. Slid over. You got to be set. You can't just slide when the guy gets to you.
Gary hits the back iron on the first free throw attempt.
That was a little slingshot action right there.
World B Free. I haven't heard that name come up in a while.
Oh, man. World B, a.k.a. Lloyd.
Lloyd Free.
Yep. I just call him Lloyd. But he was a part of that Philadelphia 76er team with Daryl Dawkins. Daryl Dawkins and George McGinnis.
Whoa, we got a technical foul. Do we have a technical foul?
So we got a foul on number 11.
And we got a technical foul, I believe, on Trevor Johnson. Is it on Johnson or no? I think that's on Rock.
He said that Lincoln Rock was talking to him, the coach. The referee said he was talking to me. Maybe he was talking to both. We'll find out. But this is an opportunity for Wesleyan here.
Free throw for Hiller is up and in.
And he gets two.
So I think the personal foul is
on Lincoln Rock.
On Lincoln Rock, and I think the technical will be on the bench. And the free throw is good for Hiller.
So it's third foul on Rock.
And now, the 1-1. .59-46 Prairie Wolves.
And again, valuable minutes here, Jeff, for Shimonitz on the bench.
Hiller at the line.
He's back in the ballgame now. Hiller wants to leave. He got one more shot. This will be his fourth. Shimonitz is back in the ballgame. He has three fouls, along with Hiller and Reimers and Dirks.
So four straight points for Wesleyan at 61-46 with 9.5 to go. Great. Back out they go. Dittmers misses the three, tipped around. Gillingham's got it. Shimonitz off the outlet. Left side, Hiller, three on the way, off. Reimers with the offensive board, puts it to the floor, left-handed lay-in.
Yeah, he needs to do that. That's big time for Reimers.
That's 11 for him.
9 rebounds.
And Lincoln Rock responds with a three. All of his points from beyond the arc, he's got 9.
Yeah, he needed that. He's had a tough assignment. Got to give something on the offensive end.
Here's Gillingham off screens. Shimonitz with 10 on the shot clock, 3 on the way, off. Rebound pulled down by Garrett Sittner, former Hastings Adams Central product.
They don't know if they needed that three-point shot from Shimonitz at that point.
Inside they go to Gary, going to working lane, up and under with the left hand, misses it, rolls off
wow.
the rim.
What a move. Right there. Nice job by Gary.
That was a good move.
Like that. Another miss, another empty trip.
We're getting to a point where maybe the clock will start to become the enemy for Buena Vista. But anything can happen here with 8 minutes remaining.
Yeah, three-point shot, man, anything can happen.
Dirks missing it. Back the other way, here comes Rock. Left side, Dittmers going to the basket with a little scoop shot underneath, missing it, and the rebound to Reimers.
Another close-in shot.
You got to finish.
Yeah, the three-point shot changes everything. I mean, you can get back in the ball game in just a few shots.
Nice backdoor cut. Reimers lays it in.
Yeah, that's Wellman basketball right there. That's what Coach Wellman wants. Patience, screen cutting, backdoor, 2 points.
McNeil for a three. Can't convert on that. The rebound, it goes to Gillingham.
Whoa,
a dangerous outlet stolen by Gary, and he lays it in.
That's a great job by Brendan Gary. That's a big steal right there.
He's been a very big part of that bench play for Buena Vista tonight. They've gotten some big-time bench points from him.
And that's just careless by Gillingham, just careless.
Dirks looking in, back over here to Shimonitz. Now to Reimers, nice move on the low block.
He keeps using his right hand there. I wish he would put that ball in his left hand and go up off the glass.
Lead at 16 now for the Prairie Wolves, closing in on 6.5 minutes. Gary in the lane, gets it to go, friendly roll.
That's too easy, man, come on. That's just too easy.
Timeout called with 6:29 to go here in this ball game. 30-second timeout taken, and it's a 14-point lead here for Nebraska Wesleyan at 67-53.
Still a lot of time. Well, I tell you, 6:29 left in this ball game, but mark it, folks. At 11:39, Jeffries fouls out of this ball game. He is their leading scorer,
and that's what kind of shifted things around and changed the tide in terms of the momentum. Now Wesleyan, coming out in the second half, had pretty good momentum that they picked up, but they weren't totally out of the woods yet. They're still not out of the woods.
Oh no! You can forget that.
There's still a long ways to go to get out and come away with a victory here at home. And what a great way to start conference play with a big matchup, though.
Well, this is tremendous. And this team, again, this team's not going anywhere. I mean, there's 14 points right now, 6 minutes, 29 seconds. That's a lot of possessions. They're missing a lot of close-in shots. The iron has been unkind for them here recently.
57 points from the starters for Wesleyan versus 38 from the starters from Buena Vista tonight. Interesting little side note there. Prairie Wolves moving the ball.
Just have to be smart. I mean, don't take that three-point shot that you don't need to take.
Hiller going to work. Turnaround, fadeaway, long, over the rim.
Or a two-point shot fading away on the baseline.
Sesma looking to get a shot going. Nice pass on the inside to Gary. Back out McNeil. Here's a 15-footer good.
Yeah, you got to do a better job of challenging. That's a good job by McNeil. Nice ball movement by the Beavers.
First points of the second half for McNeil.
And this lead can go away quickly.
Still reachable, 67-55, and I think that didn't help matters either. Turnover on Wesleyan.
Yeah, a little push in the back there. Ever so slight on Hiller. Allowed him not to catch the ball. I think if that was football, that would have been a little pass interference. But this is a big possession here for the Beavers.
Here's McNeil for a long three off the back iron. Reimers with another rebound. Clay Reimers.
Way high in the air. He thought he was Trey Young on that one.
He's got 12 rebounds tonight. 15 points and 12 rebounds. A double-double here for Clay Reimers. Shimonitz. Now to Baugh for a three. Hits it.
Well, that's a big, big, big shot. Rock tried to draw the offensive foul. It was not to be.
And the ball goes through the fingertips of Joe Lind, who's into the game. A junior out of Belton, Missouri for Buena Vista.
Yeah, didn't look it in. You got to secure the ball. Got to catch it first, Joe. He didn't secure it. Looked the other way. Thought he had it before he had it. And Rock, I think he's going to be seeing Shimonitz in his sleep tonight.
Yeah. Dirks recovers the ball. Hiller here on the left baseline. Here's Shimonitz for a three off. Hit the guide wire of the basket and it goes out of bounds.
Boy. Nice diagonal pass from Hiller to Shimonitz. Thought he might have splashed it. I would have loved to have seen Hiller go over the top. He had the height advantage.
Gary on the inside. Boy, he's bottled up.
A lot of hands.
That defense can be very feisty, so you play the passing lanes. Back inside, Rock. Sesma for a three, off. Reimers with another rebound, I believe that's 13.
He's gonna need 20 before this is over.
He's been a big part of that rebounding effort tonight. A ball thrown away. Here's a steal for Buena Vista. Rock.
Oh, my goodness.
Dish off underneath, and Shimonitz comes up with the basketball, and he's fouled in the backcourt.
What a defensive play that was. Guys, if you got that in the truck, give us that one back. That was tremendous. Oh, my goodness. Whoop! Gotcha.
Wow.
Oh, man. Two on one, and the one wins. That's just craftiness right there by Nate Shimonitz. You know, so often you want to draw the defender, make him commit, and then you can either take it or drop it off to the other player that you have running with you. Shimonitz didn't commit.
Wesleyan tonight, free throw wise, 17 of 18. Three guys have been to the charity stripe. That's it.
And Rock just fouled out there.
Chemnitz bouncing through. That's 10 of 11 for him tonight.
I imagine Rock has some folks here. No, he's from Iowa, Peterson, Iowa. Sittner might have some folks here.
He's from Hastings, played at Adams Central again as Chemnitz hits the second free throw. He's 11 of 12. Prairie Wolves 19 of 20 for 95% from the free throw line tonight. That is outstanding.
Yeah, Buena Vista's letting the game just get away from them right now.
Here's a three from Sittner off the back iron. Offensive board. The ball goes into the hands of Gary. Here's a three from Sittner. Sesma hits the three and buries the tray.
Yeah, that's the question for Buena Vista. Is there enough time now?
Well, I don't think there. Well, you're getting down to it. You got to be hitting threes, and you got to start forcing fouls. But the guy that you got to foul is not the one that's been hitting the free throws tonight. And that's five on Sesma, and he's out of the game. So three guys have fouled out tonight for Buena Vista.
So we got Sesma, 16 minutes. Rock at least had 33 minutes. Jeffrey's only 17 minutes. So out of your two of your starters, you get 33 minutes.
He had 20 team fouls tonight against Buena Vista. Chemnitz goes 12 of 13 from the line as he hits that one. 73-58. And there is no doubt that Buena Vista at this point is going to be way below their average per game. And Chemnitz hits the second free throw.
Yeah, they're cashing it in from the free throw line. Only one
21,
miss tonight.
21 of 22 from the charity stride.
You got to have those, man. You got another steal.
Peyton Priest, who comes in for Wesleyan, comes up with a steal. Here is Hiller on the other end, goes up, and he's fouled hard by Noah Schmidt.
Yeah, he was going to go with the hammer. Hiller was going to go with the slam, jam, bam. And Schmidt would have none of it. So you might be beating us, but you ain't going to dunk on us. Look at this.
Free throw from Hiller, good. It's been Hiller, Baugh, and Chemnitz that have been to the free throw line tonight.
Yeah, that's it. Three guys have shot the ball 20 some times.
22 of 23 tonight.
Of course, with Chemnitz, the bulk of those, 14.
23 of 24. 76-58, Wesleyan. This thing has gotten away from Buena Vista. Let the ball go out of bounds, and the turnover committed. It will be Wesleyan ball.
Yeah, under 3 minutes here. Almost a 20-point lead.
This is one game that those three gentlemen there on the bench that you see want to forget. But there's still that trip to Storm Lake later in the season.
Oh, you better remember there is.
January 29th, to be precise. Hiller misses a three. And that's a game that we'll probably have to keep an eye on. McNeil for a three, short. Got his own rebound. Kicked out in the far corner. Dutmers misses it. The rebound to Chemnitz. And he calls timeout. So timeout on the floor with 2:18 remaining in this one. 76-58, Prairie Wolves. Let's step aside for a quick break. We'll be back in just a moment. KTV and the Nebraska Wesleyan Sports Network. Proud to bring you Nebraska Wesleyan Men's Basketball Sports Information Director Alex Linden here at Wesleyan. It's all powered by Lincoln Electric System. And we got ourselves a 76-58 lead for the Prairie Wolves with just over 2 minutes to go.
I need to ask Alex, when is his
his calendar coming out. Pictures of Alex, you know, 12 months of the year. You haven't heard about that?
No.
Well, I'm sure there's folks out there that would buy it if he
I'm sure.
If he had one.
I'm sure.
I think we might need to put a calendar together.
I'll let you handle that.
I got enough pictures of us, okay, doing sports.
Priest for a three. Short.
A little short on that one.
And McNeil lost it but recovered. And now the ball was kicked out of bounds. It'll stay with Buena Vista.
Yeah, so if I show up with a calendar, Moats, Harris, headsets, the whole thing, all of our I mean, we got a lot of different shots together.
I know. But they see me, they'll probably throw it in the fire in the fireplace.
Well, we won't use it as a fundraiser. Let's put it that way.
Schmidt, left of the key. He'll take the mid-range shot, and he knocks it down.
That's a good job. I would have loved to have seen more from Schmidt tonight.
The problem is, you know, he got into foul trouble early. He could not get into a rhythm, like Jeffries. They look like they're very good athletes, good ball players. It's just things were not going right for them tonight. Backdoor bounce pass, kind of a dangerous one from Priest into traffic, taken away. Dish off underneath, lost, recovered. Schmidt lays it up and in as he trailed.
Yeah, look what I found. Just not enough time, enough possessions for the Beavers at this point.
76-62, and now the Prairie Wolves, a minute 10 away from closing this thing out.
Boy,
and now somebody went down. We got a guy that's down with an injury.
Gary.
Three doesn't go for Priest. Now we got an injury as Brendan Gary, as you mentioned, comes up hobbling. So he'll come out. Hopefully it's nothing too serious.
And hopefully the trainer is over there can attend to him. See what happens. Ah, he just stepped on, I think, McNeil's shoe as he came down.
Yeah.
Just tweaked the ankle over sideways.
55 seconds to go. Sittner for a three, and he knocks it down.
Sittner's got some nice Wesleyan highlights. Slow down.
Second three of the game for him, and now Reimer's lost the ball out of bounds.
And Wellman just didn't have the faintest idea what Hall is doing.
Well, you got 45 seconds left.
I mean, he's like, what are you doing?
The last thing you want to do is anything that would prevent, or that would allow, rather, Buena Vista to get back in it. Three doesn't fall. And the rebound to Baugh, and he's fouled by Sittner in the backcourt.
Yeah, that last possession, you know, Austin Hall. He's rushing. He was rushing too. You know, where was he going?
Thomas Robertson will check in.
Foul there by McNeil. Oh, nope. Actually, that might be on Sittner. No, it is on McNeil.
Free throw good for Baugh.
Clay Reimer is going to come out of this ball game.
24 of 25 tonight.
And let me check Reimer's rebounds. It's like he's 13 rebounds, 7 short of what I was asking for, but hey, I'll take it.
Second free throw good for Baugh. 25 of 26 from the line tonight for Wesleyan, 78-65.
And they out-rebounded. Uh-oh.
Ball stolen by Austin Hall. Hall going to dribble it out at midcourt. And the Prairie Wolves will go to 1-0 in conference play, 8-1 overall. Buena Vista will suffer their first loss of the season and drop to 0-1 in conference play. And they'll go 8-1 on the season so far. And Baugh just going to dribble it out. 2 seconds, one, and that's going to do it. Your final score tonight is Nebraska Wesleyan 78 and Buena Vista 65. What a game this was to start. But then all of a sudden, Wesleyan got off to a good start in the second half. Then they went on a 14-0 run, which essentially put this game away.
Well, they got hot there. They were in transition. They can make shots and put points on the board in waves. And Buena Vista, without Jeffries having a good night, Sesma didn't have a good night. Schmidt went out early. They just couldn't get into it. I mean, though the game was close. I mean, give credit to McNeil and the others who came in their stead. But, boy, I'll tell you what, Schmidt showed up in that second half and became the facilitator of a wave of points that gave them the distance they needed, and they run away with it here in the second half.
So the final, Nebraska Wesleyan 78, Buena Vista 65. A big thanks to all of you that joined us tonight. Thanks to Lincoln Electric System and Nebraska Wesleyan for their support. And for our entire crew, Jamie Wentz, John Harris, I'm Jeff Moats, saying so long. Thanks for watching. Good night from Snyder Arena here in Lincoln.
This LNK TV Sports and Nebraska Wesleyan University Sports Network broadcast was made possible by Lincoln Electric System. It's your electricity, own it. And Nebraska Wesleyan University.